गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हैव यू डन योर होमवर्क? एनी डाउट फॉर दैट मोमेंट? ओके, इन प्रीवियस क्लास व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड टू वेरिएबल्स, लीनियर इक्वेशंस इन टू वेरिएबल, इज इट? वी आर सॉल्विंग टू वेरिएबल्स, इज इट? वी आर डन द एक्सरसाइज 3.3, इज इट? इज इट? पेज नंबर 53, इज इट? यस. एंड टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद आवर first question, third part, that is, what is our third question? Third question is, x, 3x minus y equal to 3 and 9x minus 3y equal to 9. First question, third part is 3x minus y equal to 3x minus y equal to 3 and 9x minus 3y equal to 9. We want to find the solution, is it? Yes. That is, in previous class what we discussed, when we get a question, we denoted these are equation numbers, is it? Equation number 1, 2, representing by, is it? Yes. That is, this is our equation number 1 and this is our equation number 2. This is our equation number 2. That is, here we have two equations. In equation number 1, the coefficient of x is and y is marked depending to equation number 2, is it? So, I rewrite equation number 1 as 3x equal to 3 plus y. 3x equal to 3 plus y, is it? Yes. And next, we get x equal to 3 plus y whole divided by 3. X equal to 3 plus y whole divided by 3. 3 plus y whole divided by 3, is it? Yes. That is, this is our equation number 3. This is our equation number 3. We put the value of x in equation number 2. We get what? We get 9 into, that is equation number 2, 9 into, what is x? 3 plus y whole divided by 3, is it? Yes. And minus 3y equal to 9. Minus 3y equal to 9. That is, here we get what? We get 3 into, when we simplify 9 and 3, we get 3 into 3 plus y equal minus 3y equal to 9. Equal to 9. And next step is, what is our next step? That is, 9 plus 9y. 9 plus 9 plus, here when we open the bracket, 9, 3 into 3, 9, 3 into y, 3y, 9 plus 3y minus 3y equal to 9. Equal to 9. That is, 3y minus 3y equal to 9 minus 9. That is 0. That is, we get 0. Is it? Yes. And next one is, what is our next question? Next question is, what? What is our next question? Fourth one is 0.2x, is it? 0.2x, is it? 0.2x plus, that is, our fourth question is, that is, here third question we get 0, that is this is 2 for all values of x and y, is it? That is we get 0 equal to 0, that is 2, is it? Left and then right side are equal, so there is all values are satisfied. And we are going to next discussing the question fourth one, that is 0.2x 0.2x plus 0.3y equal to 1.3. And next one is 0.4x plus 0.5y equal to 2.3. These are the equations. That is 0.2x plus 0.3y equal to 1.3. And next one equation is 0.4x plus 0.5y equal to 2.3. Is it? Yes. We want to find the value of x and y. But we first what we do, we are representing as equation number 1 and equation number 2. Is it? You can take this is equation number 1 or this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2, as you like. Here I take first one is equation number 1 and second one is equation number 2. If you like to take second one is equation number 1, there is no problem. That is, in every situation the calculation, or when we calculate, when we operate, then we get a corresponding value. Here I rewrite equation number 1, that is 0.2x plus 0.3y equal to 1.3. this is our equation number 1, that is 0.2x equal to 1.3 minus 0.3y. is it? Yes. And x equal to 1.3 minus 0.3y divided by 0.2. Any doubt? That is, I rewrite 0.2x equal to 1.3 minus 0.3y. That is, x equal to 1.3 minus 0.3y divided by, or divided by 0.2. That is, 2 is going to right side. That is, here is multiplication. That is, multiplication is going to right side. Then we get division. So we write 1.3 minus 0.3y is it? 3y by 0.2. Is it? Yes. That is, next what we do? Next we do, that is, here is our equation number 3. This is our equation number 3. And when we rewrite equation number 2, we put the value of x in equation number 2. That is 0.4 into 1.3 minus 0.3y equation number 2, rewrite as 0.4 into 1.3 minus 0.3y divided by 0.2 plus 0.5y equal to 2.3. Is it? Any doubt from that? That is, we put the value of x in equation number 2. Is it? Yes. Then what we get? Here is 0.4 and 0.2. That is 2 into 0.2 means we get what we get? 0.4. That is 2 into 0.2 means we get 0.4. Is it? That is, we can simplify. Here is we get 2 and here is 1. Is it? Yes. That is, next step, what we get? Here is 2.6 is going to right side, so negative 0.6y plus 0.5y equal to 2.3 minus 2.6. 2.3 minus 2.6. That is, here we get negative 0.1y equal to negative 0.3. Is it? That is, here is 2.3 minus 2.6, we get negative 0.3. Is it? Yes. That is, y equal to negative 0.3 by negative 0.1. That is, we get 3. We get 3. That is, value of y equal to 3. That is, this is equation number 4. This is equation number 4. That is, we get y equal to 3. When we put the value of y in equation number 3, what is our equation number 3? For equation number 1, what is our equation number 1? That is, our equation number 1 is what? Equation number 1 is 0.2x plus and 0.3y equal to 1.3. That is, here y is 3. That is, 0.2x plus 0.3 into 3 equal to 1.3. That is, 0.2x plus 0.9 equal to 1.3. That is, next one is what? That is, 0.2x equal to 1.3 minus 0.9. That is, what we can do? What we do? We do, that is, 0.9 is going to right side, so 1.3 minus 0.9. Is it? Yes. That is, we want to find x, so 0.2x equal to 0.4. We get 0.4. That is, x equal to 0.4 by 0.2. That is, we get x is 2. That is, value of x is 2 and y is 2. 3. Value of x is 2, 1. Value of y is 3. Is it? Yes. That is the solution for question number 1/4 part. Okay. Next one is sixth is for your homework. In previous class, 5th is also homework, and here today 6th one is also homework for you. Write your homework in your notebook and find the solution. Okay. And second question is solve 2x plus 3y equal to 11. 2x plus 3y equal to 11. 11. And 2x minus 4y equal to 2x minus 4y equal to negative 24. Negative 24. And hence, find the value of m for which y equal to mx plus 3. Y equal to mx plus 3. We want to find the value of m. That is y equal to mx plus 3. That is our question. That is I just one more time read. I repeat. So 2x plus 3y. 2x plus 3y equal to 11. And 2x minus 4y equal to what? Negative 24. And hence find the value of m for which what y equal to mx plus 3. Mx plus 3. What we do? That is, when we get a question, we represent equations. That is, this is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. These are our two equations. First, we find the value of y and x. Is it? First, we find the value of x and y. Then we get the value of, then we get the value of m. Is it? Yes. That is, 2x plus 3y equal to 11. That is, here we can write 2x, that is equation number 1, rewriting 2x equal to 11 minus 3y. 11 minus 3y. That is 2x equal to 11 minus 3y. And next is x equal to 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2. Whole divided by 2. Is it? Yes. That is, next is equation number 2, rewriting as what? 2x minus 4y equal to negative 24. That is, here what is the value of x? X means 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2. That is 2 into 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2 minus 4y equal to negative 24. Equal to negative 24. And next one is what? What is our next one? That is, here we can find the value of y. That is, here 2 and 2 are cancelling. That is, 11 minus 3y minus 4y equal to negative 24. Equal to negative 24. This is our equation number 3. Is it? Yes. That is 11 minus 3y minus 4y equal to negative 24. That is 11 minus 7y. 11 minus 7y equal to negative 24. Is it? Yes. That is, we take the sum and we give the sign. That is, negative 3 or minus 3 minus 4y, we get minus 7y. That is, next step, negative 7y equal to negative 24 minus 11. Negative 24 minus 11. That is, negative 7y equal to negative 35. Is it? Negative 35. That is, y equal to negative 35 by negative 7. That is, what we get? We get negative 35 by negative 7, we get 5. We get y as 5. That is, we rewrite the equation number 1. That is 2x equal to 11 minus 3y. That is next step, x equal to 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2. And next step, we can rewrite as equation number 2. That is 2 into 11 minus 3y whole divided by 2 means 2 and 2 are cancelling. That is, we get 11 minus 3y minus 4y equal to minus 24. That is 11 minus 7y equal to negative 24. That is negative 7 equal to negative 24 minus 11. And next, negative 7y equal to negative 35. And y equal to negative 35 by negative 7. That is 5. Y value of y is 5. And we can put the value of y in equation number 3. We get equation number 3, we get what we get, x equal to 11 minus 3y by 2, is it? That is 11 minus 3 into 5 by 2, that is 11 minus 15 by 2, that is negative 4 by 2, we get negative 2. X is negative 2. X is, value of x is negative 2 and y is 5. Is it? Yes. You finish our answer? No. What? Why? Because we want to find the value of m. That is y equal to mx plus 3. Here now we know what is y and what is x. Or we know the value of x and y. Is it? Yes. That is, y equal to mx plus 3. That is, y means 5 equal to m into negative 2 plus 3. That is 5 minus 3 equal to negative 2m. That is, we get, what we get, 2 equal to negative 2m. That is, m equal to 2 by negative 2, we get negative 1. That is, value of m is negative 1. Value of m is negative 1. Is it? Yes. Is it? Yes. That is, next one is, any doubt? Okay, next we are going to discuss question number 3. Question number 3. That is, what is our question number 3? From the pair of linear equations, solve the following problems and find their solution by substitution method. Now we are discussing substitution method. So we want to find the solutions through the substitution method. First question is, what is substitution? The difference between two numbers is 26. And one number is 3 times the other. Find the numbers. Find the numbers. That is, I repeat. Condition is, the difference between two numbers is 26 and one number is 3 times. Is it? 3 times the other number. Find, you want to find the numbers. Here, what is the condition? First one is, difference is 26. And one number is 3 times more than other number. Is it? We want to find the numbers. That is, according to question, we can write two equations. Is it? That is, let x, y are numbers. Y greater than x. That means y is highest integer or highest number depending to x. That is, according to question, what we can write? There is two conditions. That is, one is the difference between numbers is 26. Is it? Yes. And next one is one number is other than three types of other number. Is it? Here, which number is 5? That is, we taken as y as 5. So we can write y equal to 3x. That is, this is question number 1 and this is question number 2. Is it? Yes. And so here y is 3x. In substitution method, we can rewrite as y equal to 3x. That is, here we put value of y, 3x minus x equal to 26. That is equation number 3. That is, according to question, there is already stored difference of two numbers is 26. So we can write y minus x equal to 26. And next one is y equal to 3x. Is it? Yes. That is, here clear that y equal to 3x. That is, we put the value of y in equation number 1, we get 3x minus x equal to 26. That is, 2x equal to 26. That means 26 by 2, we get 30. That is, but what is, we get x equal to 30. That is, we rewrite the equation number 2. That is, y equal to 3x. That is, y equal to 13 into 3. That is, we get 39. That is, or 3 into 30. Multiplication is commented. So 3x means 3 into 30. That is, we get 39. That is, value of x is 30 and value of y is 39. Our conditions are satisfied, is it? The difference of 39 and 30 is what? We get 26. And y equal to 3x. That is, 3 times of 30 is 39. 3 times of 13 is 39. Is it? That is the answer for, that is the solution. The second one is for your homework. Please write your homework in your notebook and find the solution. And third part is, next we are going to discuss third part. What is our third part? The coach of a cricket team buys 7 bands and 6 balls for us 3,800 rupees. Later she buys bands and buys 3 bands and 5 bands for 1,750 rupees. Find the cost of the each of the bar and batch. We want to find the cost of batch and bar. That is, first time here we want to do equations. That is, we format 2 equations. That is, according to question, we get, we take as cost of a 1 bar is 1 bar is x and cost of 1 bar is y. And this cost of 1 bar is equal to x and cost of 1 bar is equal to y. That is, according to question, what we can write? 7x plus, that is, first time she buy 7 bars and 6 bars. Is it? Is it? Yes. That is, 7x plus 6y equal to, what is the price? Total price 300. sorry, 3080 is it? Yes, according to question. This is equation number one. And next one is five, three bath and five bath. That is price is 1070. Is it? That is when we see the question, we get is it as that is 3x plus 5y equal to 1070 rupees. That is here we can rewrite, but here we can rewrite as equation number 2, 3x equal to 1750 minus 5y divided by, sorry, 3x equal to 1750 minus 5y. When we replace or rewrite the equation number 2, that is next step is x equal to 1750 minus 5y by 3, by 3. That is what we get. We get the equation number 3. We get the equation number 3. We will put the value of equation number, or we put the value of x in equation number 1. We get 7 into 1750 minus 5y by 3 plus 6y equal to 3080. That is here we can, what here is by 3, so we can put it as 7 into 1750 minus 5y plus 18y whole divided by 3. That is we multiply 3 in numerator and denominator, so we get 7 into 1750, that is 1750 minus 5y plus 18y whole divided by 3, that is equal to 3080. Is it? Yes. And next, we can simplify, that is 7, 1750 into 7. That is we get 0, 35, we carry out 7 into 7, 49, 49 plus 3, 52, 5 and 1 into 7, so we get total, that is 12,250 minus 5y plus 18y, we get plus 13y equal to 3 into 3080. 3 into 3080 is it? Yes. And next we get what? 3 into 38, that is 4, 2, 24, 2 is carry out. That is we get, what we get? 18 into 3, 24, 4 and 3 into 3, 9, 9 plus 2, 11. So we add 2 zeros. 2 zeros. That is next step, what we get? That is 13y equal to, that is one more time, 12,250 plus 13y equal to 3 into 3080. here we get is it? Yes. So next step is 13y equal to minus, here is 12,250 is going to right side. That is what is the difference?
Plus 5y
equal to 1750, is it? Yes. That is, here is 3 into 3080 minus 3 into 6y whole divided by 7 plus 5y equal to plus 5, there is no space, so I write the down, that is plus 5y equal to 1750, is it? Yes. And next is we get 11400 minus 18y plus 5y whole divided, here is divided by 7, and we can write 1750, is it? Yes. And next one is 7 is going to right side, that is here is 5y, that is 11400 minus 18y plus 35y whole divided by 7. We can write whole divided by 7, that is LCM of 5y and this is 7, so we multiplied 7 into 5y, so we get 35, that is here we get 1750, is it? Yes. That is -18y plus 35y equal to 7 into 1750. That is 7 into 1750, what we get? 7 into 1750 means 0, 5, 3 is carry out, and 7 into 7 49, 49 plus 3 52, 5, and 7 into 1 into 7 we get 7, that is 12, that is we get 12250, that is when we add these we get 17y, is it? 17y, is it? 17y equal to 12250 minus 11400, that is 11400, that is we take the difference 0, that is 5, that is 8, 0, 0, 0, that is 850. 850. That is when we divide 850 by 17, what we get? 17, we get here is 5. Is it 5? That is 17 into 5, what we get? 35, 3 and 85. That is 50. That is we can write y equal to 850 by 70, we get 50. We get 50. That is what is we taken y? Y means the cost of 1. Cost of 1. And we can also find the value of x. So we put the value of y in equation number 2, that is 3x plus 5y equal to 1750. As you like, you can put the value in equation number 1 or equation number 3. That is your choice. Here I take equation number 2. That is equation number 2 is 3x plus 5y equal to 1050. That is here y, value of y is 50. That is 3x plus 250. 5 into 50, 250. That is 250. That is 1750, that is 3x equal to 1050 minus 250, that is we get 1000 and 500. We get 1750 minus 250. We get 1500. That is x equal to 1500 by 3. We get 500. We get 500. That is cost of body is 500 and cost of body is 50. In earlier we take the multiplication is in bracket. We didn't multiplication, so that is there is a mistake. So this is the correct answer for that. This is yes, that is cost of one body is 50 and cost of one body is 500. That is the cost. That is we can apply the cost of or value of x and y in equation number 1. Because when we take equation number 1, 5x, equation number 1 is 7x plus 6y equal to 3080, is it? In previous we did what we did, that is in previous we take 7x plus 6y equal to 3800 and 7x equal to 3080 minus 6y, x equal to 3080 minus 7. We put the value of x in equation number 1, 2. What we get? We write as 3 into 3000 minus 6y by 7. We didn't make the bracket. Plus 5y equal to 1070. We only multiplied 3 into 3080. We didn't multiply to 6y. Is it? Yes, that is our mistake. That is for last we correct the base and this is the answer. That is one cost of one body is 50 and cost of one body is 5000. Is it? Sorry, 500, not 5000, 500. Cost of one body is 500 and cost of one body is 50. Is it? Yes, that is the answer or solution for the question. And I conclude my class. I wish you a good day. Take care, study well. Bye.